And joining us on Hot Copy, UNA Secretary General and Campaign Manager Toby Tiangco and Team Pinoy spokesperson Miro Kimbo. Good morning to both gentlemen and congressmen.
Morning. Morning.
All right, so many issues we need to talk about. Let's talk about the latest survey. Is this something, well, Team Pinoy is inclined to believe? Is it a credible one? Are they happy with it?
Well, you're happy always when you get a majority position of the surveys. But certainly surveys are something we always look at. It's a snapshot of what happens on that particular day when it is actually taken, or a week when the respondents are actually taken. We take it to heart. We listen to it. That's always been a major listening post by any politician.
Mm-hmm.
And both surveys, SWS and Pulse Asia, have practically been the same except for two positions. But given the 2 weeks or the 8 days that they were separate, that will probably explain it. But certainly, of course, we're happy, but it's still a long way off.
But we're talking about people like Grace Poe making a big leap. We're talking about Bam Aquino,
yes,
from 13 to 15 to 4 to 9th or 4 to 10th. Likewise, I think Grace Poe was 4 to 10.
Yes.
Also, they were the two big winners in the Pinoy slate.
Yeah, you actually had three people who made major advances. First was Bam Aquino with 11.8% increase, which is fantastic. Grace Poe had 11.2%. And you had Risa Ontiveros getting 6.8%. So these are individuals who are making a headway. I think for any candidate, you want to be advancing at this point in time. It's always who is speaking at the right time, which is critical, I think, more than anything else.
But you talked about public awareness.
Yes, yeah. Public awareness. There's a lot of room for many of our candidates because many of them are new. Risa's 79% awareness. So obviously she has like 21% more to convert. Or to expose and convert.
But remember, she also ran during the last elections, and unfortunately, she didn't make it.
Yeah, she didn't make it. But like I said, a lot of things, a lot of people will forget you in 3 years' time. And even former senators are having difficulty.
And I wanted to talk about that, too, because you have former senators that are having a little bit of a hard time. But let me go first to Una. I spoke to Congressman Tiangco during the SWS survey prior to this Pulse Asia.
Yeah.
And when we talked about it, you said, number one, there is something in the COMELEC resolution.
There's something in the COMELEC resolution, section 26A, no? Ang sinasabi doon, dapat i-disclose ng SWS kung sino yung mga nag-subscribe doon sa survey.
And
no?
Nag-commission.
Nag-commission and funded for it. No? Pero ang sinasabi ng SWS when I wrote them, sabi nila they're not obligated to say who subscribed kasi hindi daw yun ang nagbayad. But I have showed them a letter, yung kontratang pinakita nila sa akin, maliwanag na if you subscribe, you pay for the survey. Kasi ang wording doon is you fund the survey pag ikaw ay nag-subscribe.
What's the difference between who subscribed and who commissioned?
Commission is actually yun na nga yung play of words doon eh. Pero kung titignan mo yung kontrata nila na pinisenta sa amin, maliwanag na if you subscribe, you pay for the survey. Kasi tingnan mo, dear Representative Tiangco, this is to confirm our understanding that you are contributing to the fund of the Social Weather Station to conduct a special series of surveys.
Yes.
So, ibig sabihin, you're contributing to the fund to do the survey. So, that means to say, you're paying part of the survey.
And you did.
The first time.
Yes, this particular survey, the one that came out the last time, you said you didn't subscribe, you did
not
pay.
In the last two.
But two, okay. Pero yung November survey,
nagbayad kami. Kayo. Bakit kami hindi nagbayad? Kasi pagkatapos nun, ang unang usapan, 1 million. Gusto nilang iakyat ng 1.9. So sabi ko, hindi na pwede yan. And the same respondents yan. Hindi totoo yung sinasabi ng SWS na ibang respondents yan. Because dalawang kontrata yung dala ko. Isang October 31, nakasulat 1,200 respondents. Tapos, doon sa November 14, 1,200 respondents. And we have said that we did not subscribe to the last two surveys because of this.
Yeah.
Pero ayaw nila, hindi ko maintindihan, bakit ayaw nilang sabihin kung sino yung mga nag-subscribe.
But isn't that binding, that resolution that
it
you're
is,
talking
it
about?
It is, it is. That's why I'm writing to them. Sana nandito si Kong Miro, kung alam niya kung nag-subscribe yung LP o hindi.
Yun ang tatanungin natin.
No, because dito sa Pulse, I will admit that we subscribe.
Okay.
I will admit and outrightly say that we subscribe to this Pulse Asia survey.
But I don't understand what would be the difference of admitting if you actually subscribe to a survey or not. I think any politician, for that matter, who has the money, would like to subscribe to a survey. Did you subscribe to the first one? Not the first one, the more,
the
9 days ago, yeah. The SWS. Did you subscribe to that?
I honestly don't know, but I would be surprised if we didn't.
Okay.
Because we should have.
And Pulse.
And Pulse. We should have by now already. Meaning, I see no reason. I mean, if you are a reasonable individual, you want your candidates to win, you need to be able to do your surveys. And these are the two most credible survey takers or survey companies. I'd be terribly disappointed if we didn't.
Okay.
I don't know that for a fact, but I'm almost sure that we did.
Yeah.
But be that as it may, these two surveys are practically the same, except for two positions, which is part of the variables that they have. I mean, we can try to discredit all these surveys.
Mm-hmm.
It's a usual heap of shooting the messenger. Let's look at the message. I mean, that's how we have always been trying to conduct our campaign. And I think that's how we've been able to advance it, because we listen. We do not shoot the messenger. And I think, you know, no amount of... I mean, look, these guys have been doing it for the longest time. These are the same guys who came up with surveys that put ERAP way ahead in 98.
Don't question their credibility. That's what you're saying. You're not questioning.
Yes,
are you questioning their credibility?
The SWS, I just can't understand why they don't want to disclose, diba? If you want to be credible, you have to be transparent. So why don't you want to disclose who subscribed to the survey? Number one. Number two, sasabihin ko lang, no? Sila yung gumawa ng exit polls noong 2004. Hindi survey to, exit polls. Sabi nila, mananalo si GMA sa buong Metro Manila. E nanalo si GMA sa Las Piñas lang. So how can that be credible? Noong 2010, sabi nila si ERAP will land on third place. Noong natapos yung eleksyon, last survey nila yan, ha? Sabi nila third place si ERAP. Pero si ERAP nag-second place. So why did we... Okay, I will explain. Bakit sa SWS kami nag-subscribe noong November? Because Pulse never offered me a subscription in November.
Mm-hmm.
Kasi our decision was, and my decision was, we will only subscribe to either Pulse or SWS.
Why?
Because you have to compare apples to apples. You have to track it. You cannot compare an SWS survey with a Pulse survey.
No,
that's
why
my...
Why don't you compare an SWS survey to the next SWS survey?
Yun na nga yun dapat.
Okay.
Yun na nga yun dapat. Dapat talaga SWS kami at hindi Pulse. Eh kaya lang, if siningil ako ng 1 million dun sa unang survey, and the contract says, for 6 surveys, 1 million each. Tapos, after that, nung January, magsasubscribe na ako, sasabihin 1.9. Mo 1.9 na. Kasi hindi mo kinuha yung buong package, hindi ka pumirma for 6 months, at ginawa mo isa-isang buwan. Eh, ayoko na. And that's the
hindi
time.
Hindi wholesale ang bili mo.
Oh,
basically, right?
Okay. Ayun, oh. So, ayoko naman ng ganon,
yeah,
di ba?
Yeah.
Eh, kasi ang pondong hawak ko lang nun is for one survey.
I see.
So,
okay.
So nung ayaw na nila pumayag, lumipat na ako sa Pulse.
Mm.
And the funny thing is, nung lumipat ako sa Pulse, sabi nila, hindi, sige, balik na lang natin sa 1 million. So, ibig sabihin, pwede naman palang 1 million. Bakit mo ako sinisingil ng 1.9 million?
Eh, baka dapat talaga may tawaran.
Hindi, tinawaran ko yan eh. Tinawaran ko yan. Pero ang sinasabi ko lang, kung binigay yun sa amin ng 1 million, ng tuloy-tuloy, isa lang kukunin namin. Baka hindi na kami napunta sa
so,
Pulse.
So, what is the status now? You're subscribing to Pulse.
Yes.
Are you subscribing to SWS?
No more.
At all?
No more.
In the every month survey that's going to come out, wala na kayo doon?
No more. And
okay.
And I have written them a second letter insisting na maliwanag na maliwanag. You have to say sino-sino yung mga nag-subscribe. I think one reason why they don't want to say who subscribed is because they might have sold the same survey to 20 people. If 20 people subscribed, imagine at 1 million each, you sold one survey, you profited
20.
You got 20 million for one survey.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm just guessing why. Or baka.
And if that is so, what's wrong with that?
Ha? Makikita ng tao na negosyo tong ano. Negosyo tong
well, for politicians,
survey.
It's not something that you should hide. I mean, yeah. if you were in a hotly contested area,
yeah. Uh-huh.
Your area, for example, magpapasurvey.
Magpapasurvey ka pero
wow,
hindi mo papaalam.
Yeah. Eh, parang common knowledge na rin.
No. I mean, a survey for me, a survey is something that you keep top secret because that's where
really?
You see your strengths and weaknesses.
Mm.
The only reason why we subscribe to Pulse or SWS is kasi sila yung naglalabas ng result.
Kaya
ayaw naman namin makagabyado doon sa result.
Okay.
Yun lang
yung
totoo nun.
A survey you keep a secret if you're not winning.
I know, I was going to say that.
You
sorry.
Keep as a secret,
I was going to say the same thing.
If you're
I was
winning
a top
there,
contender, papalabas ko talaga yun.
I mean, you brag about it. No, I mean, just to set it aside, I think that It's highly unfair. I mean, you know, we've come to accept when they were winning, when they had a lot of senators in the previous surveys, we took it to heart, meaning it was a sign for us, it was a roadmap where to work. We simply accepted that because that's the way to do it. You embrace it hook, line, and sinker in the sense that
look at your when strengths you go and weaknesses.
In the same breath that, yeah, if the challenge is raised and if there's nothing illegal, I think SWS and Pulse Asia should. And I bet you that a great number of the UNA senatorial candidates are also subscribers there. And
privately.
There's nothing wrong with that. You need to know that's your scorecard.
Yeah.
But should they be making money? Hell, they should be making money.
How
it's
are
a business. I mean, how are they going
to
pay their thousands of employees?
Yeah.
Which I think is, let's stop talking about how the surveys are done. I mean, if at all they're not trustworthy, there are ways to actually castigate or hold them accountable. But I don't think it's fair to the thousands of employees that they have if we keep throwing brickbats on that. I mean, let's just look at the results if they're not acceptable. Because anyway, they said that Pulse is acceptable. And Pulse and SWS, like I
that's
said,
why.
Has validated
I wanted
the
to
very
go
same
there.
Hindi, teka muna. Yun na nga muna. Okay. Kung walang tinatago yung, ito, lawyer naman si Miro, yung Section 26A maliwanag yun eh. Bakit ayaw sundin ng SWS kung wala silang tinatago?
Meron pa ata akong
copy
na nun eh.
Okay. Number two, yung sinasabing pag-leading ka, linalabas mo. Ito hindi naman sa pagyayabang. With all humility, sinasabi ko, I've run 5 times already in the Votas.
Mm.
In all our internal surveys, lumang ako. Never ako naglabas ng survey ko.
Eh, hawak mo na yun eh.
Hindi ko hawak yun. Okay. Pero hindi ko linalabas. Kasi strength mo yun eh.
Yeah.
Yun ang bala mo eh. Number two,
okay.
in 2010, alam na namin na lamang si VP Binay doon sa internal survey namin. Never namin dinabas yung internal survey namin na yun. Alam na namin na makakahabol si VP Binay.
But isn't it to
pero
each
hindi
his
namin,
own?
Hindi
kung
namin,
ano man yung strategy nyo will work for you, kung anong strategy nyo
exactly.
will work for
I mean,
you, right?
Like in all major democracies, you look at CNN, you look at
okay.
Gallup, you look at AP, you look at New York Times, they have their own surveys. And whether they subscribe to or not, people actually bring it out. So, I really do see no reason, in a sense, kanya-kanya strategy. I respect the strategy of Toby, especially with the VP Binay when he was really inching closer to the Vice
All
President
right.
in 2010. But as a rule, like I said, if they have any beef against SWS, let them take it against SWS.
Wala akong question.
It's what is in the resolution
I'm
that
just saying
you want
that they have to follow the resolution. Hindi ko kini-question yung resulta ng SWS. Ang sinasabi ko lang, it's a valid survey according to the definition of COMELEC. If you disclose
Correct.
Who subscribed.
Yan lang sinasabi. I took a picture. I'm sorry. That's why I'm looking at my phone.
No, I have it.
You have
Section
it.
26A.
Let's just read that so people understand what exactly
maliwanag
we're talking
yo.
About.
Section 26A. During the election period, any person, whether natural or juridical, candidate or organization may conduct an election survey. The survey shall be published and shall include the following information. A. The name of the person, candidate, party, or organization that commissioned or paid for the survey.
Yeah.
I've written them a letter. Ayaw nilang sabihin.
Yeah.
So, I'm not questioning the results.
Yeah.
No, I'm not even questioning the results.
Thank
kung
you.
Yan yung lumabas. Kung yan yung lumabas.
ito tanong na lang.
Okay.
Itindihan ko sinasabi ni Toby because it's right here, you know. Nakasulat naman talaga. These are,
ang sinasabi ko lang, sumunod tayo.
Sumunod
lang tayo.
Pero siguro, sasabihin ng iba, Congressman Tiangco, siguro naman kung siyam sa inyong ano, yung siyam yung kandidatong pumasok, hindi mo na pagpipilitan itong specific resolution na to.
Hindi. Pagpipilitan ko yan. Kaya nga, dito sa Pulse, ako na yung nag-disclose eh. Ako na yung nagsabi, wala naman nagtatanong sa amin na we did better in the Pulse than in the SWS.
Okay.
Wala naman nagtanong sa amin, so, nag-subscribe ba kayo? Sabi ko, nag-subscribe kami dyan.
Okay. Congressman.
Just to set that aside, we for the first time, I agree with Toby Tiangco. We agree that the survey companies, as required by COMELEC, should disclose it.
Why not? Right?
I mean, you know, but that's just, you know, getting lost in the forest here. We're looking at all the small trees. I mean, let them do that, and so that they can comply with
but
the law.
But what's a small tree for you is probably not a small tree for them. You know what I mean? I mean, if there is a law that
we
needs
all
to
have
be followed,
to follow. Diba yung
it needs
poster,
to be followed
post...
whether it's for your advantage or your disadvantage.
Yeah. No, but the long and short of it, yes, that is an issue. They should comply with that, but there is a bigger issue. And that's precisely why, which is the result. Meaning, that's a significant thing. The results are not being questioned. So
yeah,
I think
they're
not questioning.
Let's talk about the result.
I'm just saying this is the same resolution na sinasabi yung poster size 2x3, hindi mo pwede ikabit sa poste.
Tapos yung sunod,
oh, bakit yun kailangan natin sundin? Bakit ito ayos hindi?
So let it be on record that we joined the call of Congressman Toby Quiano.
Very good. Okay.
Okay.
To both Pulse and SWS. Let's talk about the outcome. You guys are winning, more or less, right? You have basically, if I remember correctly, SWS, you had 9. Did you have 9? And in Pulse, how many? Although madami yan, from 4 to 12, 4 to 13, statistical tayo, marami sa kanila. But Toby, it seems like they're the Team Pinoy.
Then yung sa SWS.
Si Toby muna, si Toby.
yung sa SWS, 9 sila, 3 lang kami. Okay, dito, if you will look at mere rankings, it's 8 sila, 4 kami. But if you will look at the other side of the story, ang sinasabi din dito, pwedeng maging 6-6. Because Zubiri and Gordon are 11 to 16. Mm. So okay, they could be 11 and
correct.
12.
Yeah.
So,
pwedeng 6-6.
Pwedeng 6-6. Pero, sinasabi, kung titignan mo lang yung half of the story, it's 8-4.
Yeah.
But what does the survey say? The survey says, statistically,
right,
it's 6-6.
Understandably. That's a very good showing compared to the SWS survey, Congressman.
Well, surveys are just, you can interpret them in the same way. I mean, honestly, if you want to interpret it in your favor, you know, you're looking at 6-6. Of course, anything is possible. You're looking at the margin of error 1.8% or 3%, depending on the number of respondents. But
yeah.
I think more than anything else, what you need to look at the survey is what is cutting across to the voters.
Mm-hmm.
Well, I think the most significant thing about the surveys is that the top four positions are with Team Pinoy. And that secondly is that you look at the rest of the individuals that have gained, those are the things you look at. Who are the gainers or who are taking a giant leap? And
they're
all Team Pinoy. When you look at all the candidates from UNA, many of them are actually having almost 9-8% decline, which
but,
I think significant.
Okay, I wanted to talk about
yung may decline talaga dito is Senator Honasan and Jack Enrile.
Mm-hmm.
Pero
talagang showing ni Jack Enrile in the beginning was
No, kasi this was the time na talaga namang inupakan sila sa Javier.
Okay. All right.
So,
si Senate President.
Si Senate President, 'di ba? Si Senate President inupakan sa Javier noon.
Okay.
So this was the time, no. And sa kanila rin naman, meron naman malaki ang binaba. Si Senator Tulianis from 4 to 12 naging 9 to 15. So meron din naman, 'di ba?
Okay.
But talaga admittedly, malaki ang tinaas ni BAM at malaki ang tinaas ni
okay,
Grace.
Okay, now I want to talk
yun.
About that.
Walang
Grace
argument.
And BAM made significant leaps. And in one of the press releases I read, obviously from the camp of Team Pinoy, is that look what happened. Umalis na sila sa una. They even, except BAM, mm-hmm. of course, they even had giant leaps. They made mm-hmm. significant gains, rather, even after UNA dropped them. Right? That's what the Team Pinoy is saying.
Yes, yes.
So, parang
I think that was significant in a sense that we saw that, as far as we were concerned, in spite of the dropping, both Lauren and Cheese remain on the
one
top. In fact, their numbers have not changed. If at all, they've moved up a little bit. And you look at Grace Poing increasing by 11.2%. after she was dropped. And I think the reason there is people don't want candidates to be straddling between two positions.
You think like, so?
Yeah, that's one. Meaning, ayaw ng tao nang namamangka sa dalawang mm-hmm. with anything. Mm-hmm. They want you to take a particular position and they agreed with that position. I mean, that's our take as far as that is concerned. So, in a sense that the dropping by Toby Tianco of the three candidates did not... Fortunately for us and for the three candidates, did not have an impact. In fact, had a positive impact on Grace Poing.
Yeah, that's what you're saying, Congressman Tianco.
And then, ang sinasabi...
Parang nakabuti pa sa kanila na...
Hindi, first of all, hindi totoong hindi sila namamangka sa dalawang ilog. Namamangka nga sila sa dalawang ilog, kaya namin sila drinap, di ba? It was not their decision, di ba? Ayaw ng mga botante ng namamangka sa dalawang ilog. Lalo naman kami, ayaw naman namin ng namamangka sa dalawang ilog. Mm-hmm. Namamangka sila sa dalawang ilog. That's the reason why we dropped them.
Mm-hmm.
And alam naman namin na whether we dropped Cheese or Lauren, 1 and 2 yun eh. Yeah. Given na yun eh.
Hindi sila gagalaw. So I mean, it was not affect them.
It will not affect them.
But what about Grace po?
Alam what, naman namin na may...
What is the wisdom behind that, you think?
Hindi, paakit naman si Grace at that time eh. But the thing is, mahirap naman sumama doon sa namamangka sa dalawang ilog. Di sa kanila na lang kung talagang gagadunin lang kami.
Hindi, pero ang tanong, do you accept na nakatulong pa kay Grace po ang paglalaglag ng...
Hindi, sa tingin ko, hindi nakatulong, pero talaga may trajectory na talaga si Grace at that time. May trajectory na talaga si Grace at that time. And we saw it eh. Because bago namin siya...
Yeah, simply, it could be that people were getting aware that she is Fernando Poe's daughter.
No, if we want... No, even before we dropped her, paakit na talaga si Grace. Mm. If we just wanted political convenience, kung gusto lang namin na political convenience,
keep her. Then,
keep the three na lang para at least common eh. Pero ayaw namin ng ganun eh.
Diba? All right.
Mas mabuti na yung maliwanag, di ba?
That's why Toby is a very effective spokesperson.
I think you both are, in fairness. There was also something I read, Congressman Tiangco, about, it says, God Save the Prince Operation.
Huh?
God Save the Prince Operation. You're referring to Bam Aquino.
Yeah.
Okay, so what exactly are you saying?
Si Bam, papayag ba naman sila na matalo si Bam, di ba? And one thing about Bam, no? I think the public should know that Bam is now with the president and campaigning with the president. Sinasabi ni Pinoy na may mga nagpapanggap. And talagang they've been hitting on President GMA. Mm-hmm. Di ba? Maliwanag naman yan. They've been hitting on the past administration. Bakit hindi natin tanongin si Bam?
Sa tatay niya?
No, not only sa tatay niya. Unang-una siya, nag-serve siya ng chairman ng National Youth Commission during the time of GMA. So kung kinakasuhan ng iyong tiyuhin na si Presidente Aquino at sinasabing nandaya si GMA noong 2007 at madaming anomalya si GMA noong 2007, dapat tanongin si Bam, bakit ka naglingkod doon sa sinasabi ng tiyuhin mo na madaming anomalya? Number one yon. Number two, alam ba ng tao na noong 2004 and 2007, ang campaign manager ni GMA ay yung kapatid ni Ninoy Aquino na tiyuhin ni Pinoy na si Paul Aquino. At binigyan pa ng pwesto pagkatapos noon doon sa PNOC EDC.
And Paul Aquino is
the father of Bam.
Okay.
So alam ba ng tao 'yan, 'di ba? Mm. So kung sinasabi ni Pinoy na masama si GMA and that's the line they always take when they're in crisis, anong stand ni Bam? Masama ba si GMA o hindi? Nandaya ba si GMA o hindi? Dapat sagutin ni Bam 'yan.
That's exactly the reason why we are faring better and they're not.
Why?
Because the message and the methodology has always been that. I think, you know, whenever they see somebody advancing in the ratings, the tact is to attack. To attack that individual and to unravel all the things that they can unravel, even coming up with a tale about God Save the Prince.
But aren't those facts what Congressman Tiangco enumerated?
Well, whatever they are, there are certain facts. But if you twist the facts and give it a particular meaning...
Why would it be twisted?
How can you say that just a person participated? There were 36,000 public employees during the time of GMA, mm-hmm. with 3,200 appointees during that. She has been the longest serving president next to President Marcos. Mm-hmm. So naturally along the way, many individuals did serve. And for quite a while, until 2005, the Liberal Party was with GMA, meaning we were with GMA, we were supporting her cause at that particular time. But so many people were too. You need to be able to judge individuals. Were they part and parcel of the nefarious activities of the former president? That's when you should raise the issue.
Yeah.
With Bam, he's like with Toby here, both of us, Bam is also a TOYM awardee. He has been evaluated. Mm-hmm. He has been lauded for many things that he has done. All we're saying is that I don't think it's fair that when we... It is better always, as far as we are concerned, what we've been doing is raising the character and credibility as well as achievements of our candidates instead of looking at the other side. Mm. And that is where the separation is. I mean, I'm not saying that we have a better methodology of campaigning. That is the methodology that they've embraced. We just feel like sawaning tao dun. And again, to me, they're going back to that same tact. And uh-huh. if they continue along that path, which has been happening over the last 2 months, I think the surveys will not change, because we have seen from other focus group discussions, from other surveys, is that a positive message which is being carried by Grace, being carried by Bam more than any of our 12 candidates.
Really?
Yes.
is actually reaping dividends for these guys.
So, kung positive message yung importante, bakit si Pinoy puro pitik naman kay GMA?
Because it's...
Kasi hindi siya tumatakbo.
Hindi, pero
because it's an issue of accountability. The president feels like by some divine intervention, he was placed in that particular position by, like I said, by some divine intervention, and the reason why he was elected whenever he went around is precisely that. People did not like what happened during the last administration. Mm-hmm. And he will not stop. And you need to create that dichotomy. Now, he's always getting criticized, even by members within the party sometimes, when he talks about the president. But it is a moral compass, as far as he is concerned, to separate this administration from the past. And it's reaping dividends. Mm. Lastly, okay. is what people are forgetting is that what I keep telling my best friend Toby here is that the reason why the Team Pinoy is performing better, in my mind, is simply because it is reflective of how the people perceive the president.
The trust they have. But remember,
it's a referendum, Pinky. Yeah. It's a midterm election. People
That's
are
why it's so important for the president to have most of his candidates win.
But wait
a minute. I want to say this. Apart from, of course, the trust that this is going to be a referendum, it's really important for the president. Again, if we look at surveys, SWS, Pulse Asia, the number one most trusted public official would still be the vice president. Right?
It's better that it came from you. Kasi iniintriga na sila. Pero ito, no?
Wait, Toby, babalikan kita. We will continue our conversation with our guests, Team Pinoy spokesman Representative Mito Kimbo and Una campaign manager Representative Toby Tiangco after the break. Hot copy. We'll be right back.
What I like about social media is that the viewers get to be part of the news. You guys get to interact with us. You guys get to interact with a lot of the people who will be coming in. Let's say we have interviews of celebrities or politicians that you'd like to talk to. This is your way of getting in touch with them. And hopefully I'll get to be a great mediator for you. The latest buzz, trends, and updates in social media, it's all here on News Now.
Weather's not supposed to be complicated. When you tell people or inform people about the weather, it should be as simple and as understandable as you can. It could be fun at times, but weather is serious business. Hourly updates about the weather, it's all here on News Now.
Weather news happens here in the country or overseas. We keep you in the know. Get more than facts and figures. Get the clear picture of how events abroad impact both local and global Filipinos, and how it can help you make sense of it all. Witness how world news shape the world. The Bureau, Mondays to Fridays, 4 p.m. on ANC, the ABS-CBN News Channel.
Google it. Like it. Tweet it.
The internet has completely changed our vocabulary, and you need to catch up.
Don't wait for the revolution.
It's already here.
I'm PJ Manoto.
And I'm Lexi Schultz. Be a part of the social media revolution.
On ANC Alerts, weekdays 4:30 p.m.
Only on ANC, the ABS-CBN News Channel.
Yes, it's a hot discussion. Welcome back. With us is Una Secretary General and Campaign Manager Toby Tiangco and Team Pinoy spokesperson Mito Kimbo. Before the break, you wanted to say something, Congressman.
No, first of all, yung kay Bamdo, yung sinasabing we're twisting it. We're not twisting it. Totoo naman na nag-serve siya ng National Youth Commission Chairman. Totoo naman na yung father niya was appointed. Totoo rin naman na yung 2004 and 2007 na supposedly may dayaan ang campaign manager is yung father niya na si Paul Aquino. So, dapat sagutin ni Paul Aquino kung nandaya si GMA, ikaw na campaign manager, hindi mo alam na nagkaroon
ng dayaan. What's your culpability?
Yes. Mm. Okay. Tapos yung sinasabi naman ni Kong Miro, sa kanya ko rin narinig to, sabi niya, noong 2005, iniwanan ng LP, si GMA, kasi they realized na nagkaroon ng dayan. Mm-hmm. Diba? Yes. I heard you saying that. So, ibig sabihin, ang LP, assuming that is the reason, but I will argue that that is not the reason they left GMA. The reason they left GMA was because they wanted a constitutional coup d'etat. Kasi under the constitution, pag majority ng mga cabinet secretary ay pumirma na unfit na ang presidente, matatanggal siya.
No choice,
okay?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
And makikita mo, karamihan na may mga pumirma doon, apat doon, may isang Liberal Party member at yung iba nasa kabinete na ni Presidente Aquino ngayon. Yeah. Okay, so what am I trying
wait
to say?
Wait a minute. Let's put context.
Let me finish.
That ito yung time na umalis si na Butch Abad,
yes,
Dinky Soliman. Okay, just to put it in context.
After singing Let's Hold On Together and after Drilon saying 1 week before na Madam President,
dito
you can build Malacanang in Iloilo.
Tama.
He said that on July 1, and then on July 8, 2005, 7 days after he's asking the president to resign. Ang reason ni Miro doon is because na-realize nila na nagkaroon ng dayaan talaga. Mm. So kung na-realize ng Liberal Party na nagkaroon ng dayaan talaga noong July 2005, si Bamba, kailan niya ba na-realize na nagkaroon ng dayaan or naniniwala ba siya na hindi nandaya si GMA? I think it's a valid question. Wala namang twisting dito eh. Isn't it valid? Obam, naniniwala ka bang nangdaya si GMA o hindi?
Okay, but let me ask you this, Congressman. Why should he answer a question like that when he's the one running it and not his father?
No, because he served under GMA, di ba? Because
anybody. I mean, let's be factual here. You're young. Uh-huh. You want to be part of a youth commission. Appointed ka. You know, hindi pa naman ganun ka controversial yung administration.
Pero you
would take that opportunity, won't you?
No.
Di ba?
Ako, I can tell you straight to the point.
You won't.
Kung nalaman ko na nandaya. At as soon as nalaman ko na nandaya, katulad ng sinasabi ng Liberal Party na nung nalaman nila nandaya, bakit yung Liberal Party? Why did they withdraw support? Kasi nalaman nila nandaya. Kung talagang prinsipyo ang pinaglalaban mo, di ba, nandaya itong pinagseservisyon ko, aalis na lang ako.
Okay.
Yun lang sinasabi ko.
Yeah, but like I said, I think it's not fair to BAM. He should be judged on the basis how he performed there. It was a non-political position. It was in fact a commission that allowed him to be able to expand entrepreneurship as well as develop new skills for the youth. And he did quite well. In fact, like I said, he got a Time Award for that. Yeah. But
did you guys get it too? Are you awardees as well? Oh, congratulations. I didn't know.
Kailang mas una siya.
Mas una ako, but I'm younger.
Oo. Siya yung nagpanalo sa akin.
Alam mo, napaka-close yun. During the break, I actually found out na nagkaroon, the two congressmen, nagkaroon po ng tampuhan.
Hindi naman tampuhan.
I mean, we're very close. In Congress, we're very close. Mm. And then there were statements that came from me. Ayoko na sabihin kung ano yun. No? Okay. But it was a reaction to a statement
allegedly made by Congressman.
Okay. Ganito yun eh. Nag-press release.
Sige, wag na. Personal na masyado yun between the two of you. Alright, but at least things are okay. Sabi ko kasi my question during the break was, hindi ba kayo nagkakapikunan dalawa?
Hindi. Ako never ako napikon sa politika.
Talaga?
Ako never. Never. Hindi ko alam, baka siya napikon.
Ikaw?
Ako? Pikon? Siyempre, pikon ako.
Diba?
Ibigan ko siya. Pero, I think, you know, it is completely unfounded. But anyway, it's been...
This
politics. I mean, you know, your foe today is your friend tomorrow, of course, but you try to have as many friends as you can.
All right.
I never ako napigod. Ang masasabi ko lang doon is, once they hit on any of the three bosses of...
The three una, kings.
Not three kings, the three statesmen. Ayoko naman ng... Kasi muna dynasty, baka mamaya sabihin monarchy na kami. So, sinasabi ko lang is, once anyone hits on any of the EXCO members, I will not run away from
all right.
it. And I will defend
it
with my life.
Kailangan Wait, pag-usapan.
Which I have never done on record.
Yeah.
Which I've never done.
Which was what they were discussing during the break. Yes. All right, there's so many questions still. We have 4 minutes to go. Hello, Lauren. What is that all about?
What's that?
Yung pagtawag daw ni President
hindi ko alam yan. Hindi
era
ko alam
kay
yan.
Lauren Legarda.
Hindi ko alam yan.
And yet, apparently, there is some conflict between the former president Erap and Chis Escudero.
Hindi, yung kay Chis, nagulat nga ako when he said na sinisiraan siya ni President Estrada. Because in all of the rallies, you look at the tapes, wala naman, hindi naman siya nababanggit. Okay? I talk to President Estrada almost daily. I see him 3 times, 4 times a week. Ni hindi na mabanggit yung pangalan niya doon sa Senator private Cheese. Conversations namin. So hindi ko alam saan ang galing yun. No?
That's the sad part. I think, you know, just looking at Cheese's situation is that he's somebody who's always been there for former President Arap.
Mm-hmm.
For Vice President Binay
also.
When nobody was absolutely taking the cudgels for these guys, when they were down the dumps, Cheese was there for them. And Cheese's feelings is very founded. Okay. He has confessed that, you know, it's not what's said on stage, but what is said behind the stage.
So it's not just on stage. It's not something
He doesn't know what the reason is, but he really feels
what
very...
What exactly has he been hearing?
Well, I think he's heard that President Arap has actually been asking some allies, who are also allies of Senator Cheese, not to support Cheese.
To dump him.
And then, bakit na lang, why doesn't he name names na
dump him.
Well, like I said, I don't think he wants to aggravate it, but the hurt is quite deep that he does not seem to know what the reason is.
Wait,
mag-usapan natin yun. Baka ayaw sumang number one.
But the fact na sinabi na niya, dapat pangalanan na niya. Diba? Kasi kung yun, tinago na lang niya sa sarili niya, we will not ask him to name names.
Well, but maybe that's also an issue between the two of them that they need to resolve. Still, a number
tsaka
of
hindi companies... hindi pwedeng gamitin yung word na ilaglag. Kasi openly naman, hindi na namin siya dinadala.
Hindi ba kayo nagsabi na sa kabila parang nagkakaroon na ng laglagan?
Hindi, sinasabi lang namin. Bakit
diba
naman? Siyempre may favoritism.
Oh, okay.
Diba? Mm-hmm. Hindi naman po pwedeng sabihin walang favoritism kahit sa magulang, magkakapatid, may favorite yan.
Sa una, sinong favorite?
Ha? Siyempre, sinabi mo na. Yung mga may magulang. Sabi ni Toby, sa mga magulang, pamilya, meron talagang favoritism. Eh, yun ang favoritism sa kanila.
So, meron favoritism sa dalawang
side. Yung tatlong anak ng kanilang statesman.
I'm sorry, no?
Favorite among the magkakapatid. Favorite among the magkakapatid.
Kaya lang. May tatlong ama doon.
Kaya lang, magagalit sa akin si Senator Jinggoy. Not applicable to Jinggoy and JB. Yun, hindi ko alam kung sino favorite doon.
Wala na, we don't have time. One last thing, of course, tuloy ba? Just a yes and no, tuloy ba ang sorti ninyo sa Baguio? And ang sorti ninyo sa Baguio magkakaroon doon ng face-off?
Kami, definitely.
Tuloy. In fact, we are proceeding from North Luzon, Paakyat ng Baguio.
Wow, all right.
So, doon, tignan natin kung sino mas maraming tao.
Another point that everyone is saying, mas marami kayo. Sinasabi na una, just to tell the viewers that kompleto daw sila during their campaigns. I've covered una. Yes, they are complete. Team Pinoy daw, puro representatives, etc. But I'm sorry, wala na tayong oras.
Only because we have doubled the number of sorties that they have.
So, nagkakaroon ng ano... separation.
Yes.
Hindi, nahihirapan kami sa sorties because kami ang sumusunod sa official business ni VP Binay. Hindi namin siya, we cannot request him not to do his duties.
Correct.
But kung saan siya may trabaho, doon kami sumusunod.
Alright.
Kaya nahihirapan kami.
Ganun din kami. Pero nagsasorty okay. kami kahit wala ang pangulo.
Alright, so Baguio City, possible face-off between una senatorial candidates and Team Pinoy. Congressman, gentlemen, thank you so much. It was a good discussion. And of course, good luck to both Team Pinoy and UNA.
Thank you.
And that's Head Start today. I'm Pinky Webb. Have a nice day, everyone. Stay tuned for Mornings at ANC.